Okay, very good morning to all of you. We'll begin now with a new chapter. Yes, so we have covered house property, we have covered salaries also. Two heads of income dummy. Done. Easiest HP was easy.
Yes.
Now again, one head of income is over. Compare that with another, that becomes easier, no?
Yeah.
No?
Yes, sir.
Right? So compared to salaries, HP is quite easy, right? And now compared to PGPP salary, still not easy. Okay. PGPP is, let me tell you, bachcho, PGPP is very, very logical in a way. Okay. It is logical. And there will be not too much of by-hearting what we have to do it in salaries. For salaries, for so many provisions, perquisite, exemption, lease of the following, we have to remember so many things, no? Where fraction of the year is there, when 15 by 26, where 1 by 2 and all of that, 1/3, 1/2, you know? So PGPP is like one of your most, again, logical heads of income as well, right? Now, if you remember again, bachcho, the five heads of income, I had told you the four heads of income will be revenue based and only one is, bachcho, what, capital based, you know? Right? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
So like I said, again, if I give you example of that, again, builder, real estate, you know? So builder is going to create a, let us say, building or some residential flats or bungalow or whatever, you know, bachcho, all of you, isn't it? So for him, which kind of income it is? If he sells this for a particular flat, property, whatever, then?
Business income.
It is his business income. Right? PGPP. All of you. Right, everybody?
Okay.
But if an individual, let us say, individual who earns salary income, okay, pay attention. But an individual who earns salary income, he buys such property. He buys this property, okay? And then he, in future, later on sometime, he sells it. Okay, in that case, for this individual, it will be which kind of income? Will it be business income?
Capital gain. No, no.
Yes. Capital income. Okay, income. Or capital gain. Right, everybody tell you? Yes. Now, again, from importance point of view, okay, pay attention. I think I told you in salary head of income, is it a very remunerative head of income for professionals like us? Did you understand my question? I had shown you statistics of income tax returns, hai na? Statistics, that means highest number of which type of income tax forms were filled, which having which income?
Salary
income, hai na? Like whatever number of crores of people were filing income tax returns, highest number of that is of only or mainly salary income. But what was the problem with salary income from professionals' point of view, from like people like us? It is not a very remunerative field for us. Okay, hardly, I mean, there is no fees which you collect for filing an or income tax return having only mainly salary income. Isn't it, bachcho? Correct? But
yes.
Even capital gain, when I say capital gain, the amounts involved in capital gain will be huge. But again, it is not a day-to-day transaction. No? So that is the main difference between revenue and capital. Revenue will be something on regular basis. Capital will be not on regular basis. You know? So again, from a professional's point of view, bachcho, capital gain cases will be a little bit lower compared to PGBP. Understood? So this chapter, in fact, is again very, very, very practical or very important from your syllabus point of view is there, but even from professional's point of view. All right, Elio? Because companies, your firms, partnership, LLP, every niche, every shop also, small shop you see, all of them, they go through this head of income or they have to basically go through this head of income. Even your small chai wala, hai na bachcho? Anybody you can think of, gol gappe wala, all of them, or you can pani puri wala, whatever you want to think of, all of them are bachcho, doing what after all? Business. And isn't it all of you done till you understood? Correct?
Yes.
And profession as well. Right, everybody? Profession as well. Right? So obviously, first basic things we are going to understand, what is business? What is profession? That basic, at least you have to understand or no? Like in salary, do you remember when are we going to say an income is salary only and only if, bachcho, which kind of relationship is there?
Employer-employee.
Remember that example we have done of that actor getting salary income from producer or the actor directly getting associated with the multiple producers. Remember, Tilya, bachcho? Right? Then a very important example of salary of a partner in a firm. Salary of a partner in a firm, bachcho, which head of income it is? It is PGBP. Because in salary, in partner and firm, they are not employer-employee. Okay? Partner and the firm is as such, bachcho, one and the same, isn't it? Isn't it, bachcho? Correct?
Yes.
All of you? Yes, Shilia? We'll go ahead, everybody. Yes. Okay. So we'll have to understand what is business and what is profession. Then we'll have to see charging sections. What are sections we are going to see? So very important, you can say chapter also. Yes, lengthiest chapter comparatively. Okay, overall. It is one of the lengthiest chapter because there are many provisions which we have to see. Okay, everybody. Done, Dalia? So let's check, Bachu, what is business, what is profession and all of that. Yes or no? All right. Let's go ahead, everybody.
Okay.
So first of all, Bachu, what do you think? Business or profession is one and the same?
No.
Oh.
Yeah, not the same. Okay. But let it be business or let it be profession. Pay attention. Let it be business or let it be profession. Whatever it is. Chapter applicable will be this only, no? Chapter applicable will be this only. This particular PGPP chapter will be applicable to us. And let it be business of the SSC or let it be profession of the SSC. Chapter is this applicable. That means provisions of this chapter will be applicable even if it is business or profession. Okay? Fine, Dilio? But in a way, Bachu, they are kind of mutually exclusive. Mutually exclusive means what? What is business will not be profession or what is profession will not be business. It is only a matter of, you can say, definition or terminology. Okay, we will just put them in a particular box. This is business and this is profession. Then they are separate boxes. Okay. As such, it doesn't matter from calculation or computation point of view. Doesn't matter much. Okay. Most of the provisions are exactly same for both of them. Doesn't matter. All right, everybody. But yes, you should know the difference between business and profession. Clear, everybody? Done till here. Okay. So check. What does usually Bachu, section 2 gives us? Anywhere in any of the acts, most of the acts?
Definition.
Correct. Then we had seen something about agriculture or agricultural income was given to us in section 2.
Yes, sir.
Agriculture was defined or agricultural income was defined?
Agricultural income.
Agricultural income was defined. Do you remember or no? There are four types of agricultural income, right? Do you all remember? Okay.
Yes.
So check section 2 now, where we are going to check, where we are going to get the definition. Business, everybody. Includes means what? Inclusive definition, wide definition, yes or no?
Yes.
Any kind of trade, commerce or manufacture or any adventure, any you can say activity or concern in the nature of trade, commerce or manufacture. Again, a very, very general, simple definition. Any business you could do, any trade or commerce or manufacturing, buying, selling, trading, manufacturing, whatever. Yes, everybody. But the main purpose of that obviously will be what in all these cases?
To earn the profit.
To earn the profit, exactly. Are we talking about charitable activity? No, we're talking about earning the income. Hai na, bachcho? Achha, tell me, bachcho, over here, are they saying anything about legal business? Tell me.
Yes. Not really. Not really.
No.
Not really.
We had seen this, if I remember, in chapter number 1 also, basics of income tax. That time I told you, Bachcho, income tax department or income tax law does not do any discrimination. Nothing at all. About what type of income. They are mainly just concerned that you are earning income that is good for us. Isn't it, Bachcho? Now you need to tell me, Bachcho. Now whenever the department raids, they do raiding or no raids, and then they find out some kind of, you can say, unaccounted income. Now that unaccounted income may be illegal income also, but don't they tax it? Obviously they tax it. So even if the income is from illegal source, doesn't matter, it will be taxed. Are you understanding, Leo? So even if I'm talking of income, I'm not talking about expenditure, I'm talking about what? Income. Understood, Leo? Let the income be there. Department is mainly concerned about what? Income. Is it legal or illegal? They are not as such concerned. If it is income, they will tax it. Isn't it? So if at all, let us say, I'm just telling you again, from your thinking point of view, I'm telling you this. And even if it is an illegal business, that will still be taxed because they are saying what any trade, commerce or manufacturer, whatever it can be, even if it is legal, illegal, it is following other norms, other departments, other laws, they are properly following or not following, that is none of the concern of income tax law. Understood, everybody? It is doing less pollution or more pollution. If safety standards are there or not, quality controls are there or not, income tax law is not bothered with that. They are just saying if you're earning income, you will be taxing it. Okay, it has to be any trade, commerce, or manufacture, or any, you can say, activity, adventure. Then tell everybody, it is a very, very general, very, very simple definition. Yes, everybody?
Yes. Okay.
But check. Now, manufacturing word was used, bacho, over where? In the definition of business. Hai na, everybody? Manufacturer is there, no? So what does bacho manufacturing means? Means a change in the non-living physical object, okay? Or any article or thing. What is there, bacho? A change. I think I had used this word, bacho, if at all, if I remember, again in chapter number one. What was the word I had used? I think it was transformation something. Hai na? Transform means what? Change. No? If you remember again, I had used what kind of test to determine what is manufacturing? Because that time I was discussing with you excise. And excise is levied on what? Bacho? Manufacturing. You know? And for manufacturing, I use the word transformation. So when you say there is a transformation or change, very good, Anura. Very good. It is a name test. And what? Use test. You know? And I gave you a couple of examples, if you remember. I gave you a very simple example. First of all was, let us say, a stone was there, correct? Let me write on you. H2O to H2O. But in solid form and in liquid form. Remember something, bacho? Liquid form was what? What do we call it? Wacha. And a solid form, bacho, what do we call it?
Ice.
Hai na? All of you? Is the property same? Bacho. Are the content, let us say, property of both of them same? Yes. But is the name, is the name same? No.
No.
Is the purpose also same? Maybe not. Hai na? Maybe not, isn't it? In that case, is there a transformation? Is there a manufacturing, or you can say change from this to this? Yes, it can be manufacturing. Hai na, bacho? Because it is not a kind of a natural process. Right, everybody? So even if you are selling water, but in bottle. Hai na? Everybody, that is again manufacturing. Okay, everybody? Done till here? Then I had given you an example of what? If you remember. That quarry stones. Hai na? Hai na? Quarry stones, remember? Quarry stones. What? You get lots of those big stones from the mountains. And it is sold as what? Let us say marbles, you know, or tiles, or what do you call it? Granite or graphite, something you call it, no? Granite and all of that. You know, bacho? Ultimately, what you're putting in the on the floor is a stone only. But what is the process, bacho? Is it manufacturing? Yes. I told you that it is, let us say it is a very big stone. And the big stones of tons of kgs, they are bought at in the factory, you know, and they are cut into what? Slices. Remember? Do you know this or no? Everybody? Correct. And what is sold again then? These slices or pieces are sold now. As you can say, tiles, marbles, granite, whatever it is, you know, bacho? Right? So ultimately, what you are got is stone, you're selling a stone. But it is called as tiles or some other name. But there is again a process involved over there. Remember earlier, there is a transformation. There is a transformation. Hai na, bacho? Even if you say, bacho, groundnut. And groundnut oil. Tell me, bacho. Is it again same? No. Is the use same? No. Is there some process involved for transformation? Yes. It is. All of these are bacho, what? Manufacturing. Clear, everybody? Tell you? Yes? Done on all of you? Understood? Let's go ahead, everybody, then. So whatever process they're talking about, okay? Of a non-living thing, and make it is making some change. So resulting in transformation of the object, resulting in what bacho? Transformation of the object or article into a new and a different object or article, or having a different name, character, and use, isn't it? So groundnut oil is essentially groundnut. But again, the name is different of both these products. Let us say a shopkeeper is selling groundnut. Yes. And a shopkeeper selling groundnut oil. Will the tax rate will be same exactly? May not be. Are they sold again in the same container, same packets? May not be. And there is lots of, again, process involved for conversion of groundnut into groundnut oil also. They are also different. Obviously, definitely called also different. Used also differently. Isn't it, Bachcho? Right? So, bringing into existence of a new or a distinct object or article or thing with a different chemical composition or integral structure. That means you're putting some, you can see again, some process by which you are converting itself or bringing itself a new product. For let us say tire, Bachcho. Again, tire mainly has what? We had seen this in the chapter of agriculture, isn't it? But again, you are bringing itself a new product into existence. You're not merely just converting it, but bringing a new product into existence, but by some chemical or some basically process. All of you understood?
Yes.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Pakka. So that is business and that is your manufacturing, which we have understood right now. Hena, all of you? All the big companies, or you can say manufacturing companies, Bachcho, they are what? They are doing business or profession, Bachcho. Car manufacturing, paint manufacturing, textile manufacturing, whatever you can think of, electronics, whatever. Hena, they are all, Bachcho, what? They are doing business. Understood? Pharmaceutical, Bachcho, is what? Again, tell me, pharmaceutical. Pharmaceutical, understand, no?
Manufacturing.
Yes, that is again manufacturing. Whatever, again, which involves some process, something or the other, that is all Bachcho manufacturing, isn't it? Now tell me. What about software then? Is there an input-output involved in software?
Yes.
Is there any transformation? What about software? If a software is created or whatever, let me see. Again, it is a profession or it is what? Business. Company providing softwares. What will it will be? Business or profession?
Business.
It cannot be both, Anurag. It cannot be both. That is what I was telling you. They are kind of mutually exclusive. What is business is not profession. What is profession is not business is what we understand or say. Okay. So we call it as business. Okay. I'm talking about this. Companies selling software, or you can say any assessee doing the, you can say, buying, selling of software or creation of software, right? Everybody tell you, yes. Now, Anurag, a person providing service, let me say an IT professional, pay attention. Are you understanding till here? Let me give you a very nice example. Let me say we have a company known as TCS, hai na? Everybody, okay till here? Tata Consultancy Services. Now pay attention. Everyone pay attention. TCS. TCS into what? Again, IT. Yes?
So you are now audible.
Am I audible or not?
Audible.
So you might have some internet issue, okay? Please check. Done till here, all of you? Pay attention. Yeah, yeah. Let us say if I use the, I'm using example of the company TCS, Tata Consultancy Services. Now, what it is again an IT company. Yes.
Yeah.
Whatever income TCS earns, it is what income? Business income or professional income?
Professional.
It is a
business
income. Okay, it is a business income. Okay, for the company. Yeah. For any legal entity which is into providing softwares. All right, Elia? It is not a profession. It is a business income. Okay? Let us say Zoom. We are using Zoom or any YouTube or whatever. You know? In that case, whatever income they are earning, Zoom or YouTube or whatever, any other software which we use for encryption, for seeing video lectures, whatever, that is a business income. Right, everybody, Elia? Okay? For the company. Pay attention.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now let us say over there are certain employees. Pay attention now. Okay, there are certain employees. Okay. and TCS pays them salary, obviously, or whatever. Let me not use the word any salary, but let me say what you think. And it pays some money to the employees. Then from employees' point of view, but which kind of income it is? Salaries.
Salary.
Yeah, because there is employer-employee relationship. Right, everybody? All have understood earlier?
Yes, sir.
But now let us see. If there is an independent, okay? If there is again an independent, you can say professional. You know, all of you. Isn't it? Independent, professional. And he's selling his skills. Selling what to his skills. You know, all of you. All of you. Right? In that case, this person can be treated as he's into a particular profession. Okay? He's into a particular profession. So basically, when I compare the just normal business and profession, okay? A profession is something a person is identified with. I'm using the word which a person, or you can say individual. Are you understanding? All of you? Huh? Let us say a stand-up comedian. You understand comedian, hai na? A stand-up comedian. Hai na? He's earning income, okay, by doing some shows and all. That is why. Because of his skills or because of some manufacturing process, any trade, commerce, what do you think?
Skills.
Theater person, you know, no? Theater person, the celebrities, or you can say now lyricist, you understand, lyricist, director, whatever you can think of now. Sports professional, sports, and a sports athletes, bacho, right? Chartered accountants, company secretaries, CMAs, architects, doctors, all these people. What do you think, bacho? They're earning income because of the skills or some manufacturing, trade, commerce?
Skills.
Mainly because of lawyers, I said. No? Lawyers also, correct? Eh? Mainly because of bacho.
Skills. Right?
Understood, Elia?
Yes, sir.
Advisor, any kind of consultant, advisors, mainly bacho, they have some skill or skills. Investment advisor or any kind of advisor. They're all bacho what? Professionals. Understood, Elia? Right? So, in a way also, I can say that if the individual is not working, okay, that particular individual, whoever we are talking about, that sports person, doctor, lawyer, if he is not working or he doesn't work or he himself is not earning income, in that case, bachu, that is not a profession. He will not be earning that professional income. Let me say there is a doctor, okay? Pay attention. Only if he goes to dispensary, you know, dispensary, okay. He will earn which income, business income or professional income? His own business. Clinic, dispensary. Why are you seeing again business? Doctor going to his own clinic, dispensary. Doctor do business or profession?
Profession.
So profession. Doctor log hardal kar lenge tumhare ghar ke bahar. Doctors are doing business. It is good as a rumor and kya bolte usko? In COVID times, lots of businesses happening by hospitals and all. Okay, but still. I'm talking as an individual. Keep that in mind. Okay. Not as a separate legal entity. I'm talking as an individual. Okay.
Okay,
all
sir.
Of you. Doctor, look. Koi tumko treatment nahi dega. Otherwise, you will keep on saying doctor are doing business. Okay. So, doctor going to his own dispensary clinic working. That is what? Business or profession? That is profession. Right, everybody?
Yes,
if tomorrow
sir.
He doesn't go to the clinic, will he earn this income, professional income?
No.
Are you understanding or no?
Yes, sir.
If the doctor does fixed deposit, he makes some investment, fixed deposit, and he earns interest on the same. Is this his professional income?
No.
This is income from other sources.
Yes.
If he works, doesn't work, he's going to earn interest. That is separate.
Hmm.
Are you understanding? So mainly, what I'm trying to tell you here is that if a person stops working, a professional person stops working, it is very much possible that he will not earn that income at all. No. Are you understanding?
Yes, sir.
The difference between business and profession. If tomorrow the chairman of TCS retires or 500,000 employees retire, they leave the job, does that mean TCS will be over completely? No. Mm. Business, or you can say manufacturing or something, it is like a set practice. Set. You can see all the mechanisms and everything. It will keep on going. It is not dependent as such only on one single person, no? Or skills of one single person. Remember, understood earlier, everybody?
Yes, sir.
So, but profession as such is dependent mainly on, you can say, if tomorrow Virat Kohli stops playing, will he earn that income, professional income?
No.
He may earn from endorsements, advertisements, or other things. That is different income. I'm talking about mainly because of his own skills. Understood, everybody?
Yes, sir.
All right.
So, what will be the case if the if there is a multi-specialist hospital and the doctors are working?
Doctors are working how? There is some arrangement?
Yes, maybe.
See, in multi-specialty hospitals, what I've seen is a person makes the service available, or you can say infrastructure available, and there is agreement between the doctors and the, you can say, that hospital. Okay? Let me use the word hospital. Hospital and the doctor, there is some arrangement. That doctor will come once in a week, twice in a week, whatever. And then there will be a fee sharing. 70, 30, 60, 40, whatever. Fee sharings. Okay? But again, from the doctor's point of view, it is profession only. No?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
Yes.
So actually, doctors are hired, na? In multi-specialist?
Now, it depends from contract, no?
Okay.
It depends on the contract.
Okay.
See, if he wants to provide a dentist, the dentist may come once or twice in a week.
Uh-huh.
Even not just for multi-specialist, you can talk about any normal hospital also, no? Even in normal hospital also, you will see a specialist. He will not come daily. Or even if he comes daily, only for 2 hours. Is he an employee of the hospital in that case?
No.
He's a visiting doctor, right? Whatever you're calling it as a visiting doctor.
Yeah.
So there's a contract between the hospital and the doctor. Now tell me from doctor's point of view, which kind of income it is?
Profession.
So again, it's professional income. He's visiting there mainly because of his skills.
Right.
Those who have already covered syllabus, please understand. Those who have already covered syllabus and who are revising right now in my class, pay attention. If I say a hospital, okay, let us say. Okay.
Mm.
And there is a doctor.
Mm.
This doctor is, let us say, full-time doctor of the hospital. Full-time doctor. Do you understand? General surgeon, whatever. Okay.
Yeah.
Then is he an employee of the hospital or not? Tell me.
Full-time doctor.
He is employed.
He is employed. Okay. When I say full-time, the entire direction, supervision, control, which patient to attend, which not, what to do, what not to do, everything. He is a full-time employee. He is not a visiting doctor. He is a full-time employee. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Let me just write down the name A over here. A doctor. B doctor. Mm-hmm. Let me say he is a specialist or he is a visiting doctor. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Now understand, bachcho. Now obviously, hospital is going to pay money. I'm just using the word money over here to both of them. From A's point of view, bachcho, what kind of income it is? Which head of income?
Salary.
Yes.
Employee and B's point of view, bachcho, which kind of income it is?
PGBP. Professional.
Yeah.
Those of covered syllabus, pay attention. Those of you already revising here right now with me. Let me just quickly touch upon TDS. Others, don't worry. Jinka nahi hua hai, don't worry. Okay. You tell me now. This you have to understand. Na, everything is kind of logical. So, when hospital pays salaries to Dr. A, which section TDS? Ye apni halat hai, na? No, nobody?
94J.
Salaries, Baba.
No,
1 minute. Okay. And when the money is being paid to the doctor, Dr. B, visiting doctor, professional fees is being paid to him. Which salary will be, what TDS will be deducted? So which section? 194J. Those who are done. Those who have not done the TDS, do not worry. Okay. We will be doing all of this later. All right. All of you understood earlier?
Yes, sir.
Let us say today I'm teaching also on an academy. Am I a full-time employee of an academy? No. Do I get salary? No. I get professional.
Professional.
We also call it as professional fees. No. Professional?
Mm. Yes.
Isn't it? Now, whenever you are also as a patient visiting a clinic or a dispensary to a doctor, whenever you are visiting a doctor, as a in a dispensary clinic, whatever private clinic, you pay 200 rupees, 500 rupees, 800 rupees visiting charges. I mean, that is what professional fees for him, no?
Yes.
Is, you can say consultancy fees or visiting fees, bachcho, or professional fees after all for him, you know? All of you?
Mm.
Understood, Leo? The same thing with doctor, architectures, lawyers, all of these people are earning which income, bachcho? Professional
income.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this, now please pay attention. The same person, I mean, same person means same category of person. Having, you can say, same set of skills. But it depends now whether he's a full-time employee or he's a not a full-time employee. You know? That will change the head of income. Isn't it, bacho? All of you got it earlier?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes.
Now, please pay attention. Now, again, profession is a little bit, you can say, a category. Okay. So profession includes vocation. Vocation means you can say training, or you can say something where you're getting trained. Okay. Vocational courses. Have you heard of this vocational courses? Have you heard of this course? ITI something, industrial training, something institute. Not IIT, okay, ITI something. Especially
yes,
those people who are not that great in studies, they do this kind of courses, which require skilled workmen in the companies, manufacturing companies. Like you can say plumber, welder, electrician, all these courses are also provided. Okay.
Mechanic.
Profession includes vocation. Okay. Drilling, willing, whatever it might be. So whichever these kind of people are required in manufacturing units or wherever manufacturing usually happens. Understood earlier? Okay. Now, even you might understand, again, a builder or a real estate person, eh, whether he himself does all the work, he hires people, no? He hires contractors, and that contractors, bachcho, has different set of people with different skills, or you can say for different use. One is going to do only brick layering. Another is going to make only cement mixture. Another one is going to then do only plaster. Okay, then there is other so many work, bachcho. Separate work. Are you understanding? Everybody? Yes? Okay, so check. We are in profession mainly, bachcho, always think from the individual's point of view. Understood, Leo? In profession case, bachcho, mainly your assessee will be individual. Okay, so it implies professed attainment. Attainment means achieving something. A special knowledge. Okay, a special, what did I say? Knowledge. As distinguished from just normal skill, or you can say special knowledge, which is to be acquired only after patient study and application. Again, it is a definition given to us, like patient study and application means it is not something which skill is not something which you get it just in one single day. Okay, it takes, let us say, lots of practice and lots of, you can say, time also. That is the reason we see, you know, doctors are not doing just work. We call it as practice. Even chartered accountants, what would you say? Practice. Do we call it as perfection as such? No. Are you understanding or no? Everybody? So whatever the practice they are doing, it is not merely because they have a degree. They have lots of knowledge also same, and they are applying that knowledge for a quite big period of time. Now, let us see, if I say doctor, CA, any professional, architecture, bachcho, or you can say lawyer. Now, please tell me, are they identified as a group or not? Identified as a group. When I say group means what, you can say they have some kind of association, or whenever tomorrow they want to make some protest, do some protest, they are together. They identified as a community. Are you understanding earlier? They are identified as a community. Understood or no? Everybody?
Yes.
Can any person who has not done law, can he fit into that? No. Only those persons who have completed the, you can say, degree of law, they will be falling into that. Yes, everybody? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Can I just directly by default put architecture into lawyer or lawyer into architecture? No.
No, no.
All of them have a separate set of skills which they have acquired over a period of time by lots of studies, and they're identified also as a group or community. Understood, everybody?
No.
So even your sports athlete, but your sports wale, your celebrities, your actors, everything who are involved as well, let us say in film industry, hai na bachcho, every one of them who is having some particular music composer, lyricist, singer, all of these are what bachcho, they are into profession, not business. Understood everybody? Ayana?
Yes, sir.
Tell me about a painter. What do you think?
Vocations.
Hai na bachcho? I mean, are you understanding the difference over here?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Now let us say bachcho, if I am a, what do you call it as a, exhibition hall. I am an exhibition hall means, let us say I own a hall. Okay? Have you heard of this word exhibition hall?
Yes.
What happens over there? You put lots of some items over there. It can be any items. People come, visit, check. They like it, they buy it. Right?
Yeah.
Isn't it? That's it. Now, if at all I am owning an exhibition hall. Okay? And I make all the arrangements. Lots of paintings, this and that. I tell the whoever have created that. I tell them, you come, you showcase, you explain whatever it is, you sell it. You know? And then I'll be taking some commission out of it. Right? So if I am the owner of the exhibition hall, which kind of income it is for me? Business or profession?
Business.
This business, is business income. Very good. Very good. Very good. This is my business income. But I enter into some arrangement with the, let us say, painter whose paintings I am exhibiting. For painter, which kind of income it is?
Profession. Vocation.
Are you understanding, bachcho, everybody will hear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Something or the other, skills here are involved. They're identified as a group. Okay. And lots of study, and you can say application. Study doesn't mean just our academic study. Okay. Study can be anything else also. I mean, understanding a particular work. Okay. Done.
Yes, sir.
Isn't a Breaking Bad dekha? Anybody, have you seen Breaking Bad?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So lots of after patient study and application. Okay. So any even if illegal income, bachcho, it is still taxable. Understood, everybody?
Yes,
sir. All right. Let's go ahead, everybody. So our assessee in this chapter, bachcho, hai na, is which assessee, bachcho? Is he a salary assessee now? He's earning salary income? Obviously not. He's a risk taker. That means he's doing some business or profession. Now you tell me, but when I say risk taker, he has some business or profession means, what do you think? Will there be inflows as well as outflows?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Cash inflow and cash outflow, butcho?
Yes.
All of you agree, till you're simple?
Hmm. Yes.
Achha. And what is the intention or motive of this inflows and outflows? What should be higher? Inflow should be higher or outflow should be higher?
Inflow.
Inflow should be higher than the outflow. Hai na? But in cash inflow should be more. And that will result into what then?
Profit.
Profit.
Very good. Very good. Simple, Dilya?
Yes, sir.
Now did you understand, bachcho, meaning of the word, this is my net profit, let us say.
Hmm.
Hai na? This is my net profit. And let us say all the inflows, I can call it as my gross receipts. Simple delay or language, everyone is understanding?
Yes.
Whatever money I get, that is my gross receipts, let us say. Turnover, if I don't know I'm doing business, yes or no? Everybody?
Yes.
Ayana?
Yes.
Okay. And from that, you are reducing my outflows, I mean expenditures, let us say. Isn't it,
yes,
everybody? Understood? And
yes.
Then because of that, I'm getting my net profits. Okay, I mean, what will be taxed? What do you think? Gross inflow will be taxed? Gross cash flow, cash inflow will be taxed, or net profits should be taxed?
Net profit.
Net profit will be taxed for this chapter, logically speaking. You know? Isn't it, everybody?
Yes,
so do you remember that's why I told you in the chapter of salary, what happens? Salary nothing but bachcho, pure profits. Or salary itself is your net profit. Why? Because from salary, nothing is allowed as a expenditure. You go to a movie, you go to a, you can say, any kind of meeting, any kind of food expenditure, any kind of your personal expenditure also, let us say. Okay, all of you. That is not allowed to be reduced from your salary income. Are you understanding or no? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Any kind of personal or even if it has like 20% business or 20, and 80% personal or whatever it might be the ratio, but still that expenditure is not allowed to be reduced from salary. That is the reason we have that section 16(1)(a). Standard deduction. Standard. So blanket amount they have given. Okay, this is your deduction. Okay, they don't now believe in any other kind of deduction, isn't it, bacho? Right, everybody. But many people, what they do, business people, professional people, people, bacho, any kind of expenditure. Okay, any kind of expenditure. You never know. Okay, but any kind of, let us say, very very important expenditure for the business, that will be allowed as deduction or not? Everybody. That will be allowed as deduction. Now, when I use the word virtual deduction, please don't go to chapter 6A or section 80C and all of that. When I'm using the word virtual deduction, it means what? Deduction from the income or gross receipts. Are you understand till here? Everybody?
Yes.
Till here, everybody? Right? Okay. Now, every head of income, always the first section of that head of income will be what? Very good, very good. Amazing, amazing. Without charging section, rest of the remaining sections are irrelevant. No use at all. Without what, bacho? Charging section. Understood earlier? Remaining sections, now you tell me logically, remaining sections after the charging sections are, can I say, computational sections?
Yes.
Computation. That means they are going to tell you how to compute income under that head of income. Hai na? All of you understood or not till here?
Yes, sir.
First section always is what? Your charging section. And the remaining section will be your computational
section.
Everyone understood till here? Simple?
Yes, sir.
All right, all right. So let us check. What is our charging section for PGBP? Hai na? All of you? Chalega? All right. Section 28. Can anyone tell me what was section 27? Because we have not covered that. But still, do you remember? Achha, which head of income? Section 27?
House property.
Yes, it was house property. It was about your deemed
owner.
Okay.
Deemed
owner. See later on in clubbing chapter. Okay. Section 20. Please pay attention. Income chargeable to tax under this head, that is PGBP. Okay. Again, it is going to be a very, very big definition, and we are not going into entirely. And we are just giving you some, I can say, other pointers that these things will be taxed in this chapter. Okay. Pay attention. Income arising to any person by way of profits and gains from business or profession or vocation also. So, profession also includes your vocation, some kind of skills, some kind of training involved, and you are doing a particular work. Okay, everybody. Yes. An income derived from any trade. A trader, bachu, what do you think a shopkeeper does? Your retail shopkeeper. He buys and sells, trading.
Yes.
An agent who works for commission, trading. You know?
Yes.
So income derived by any trade or profession or similar associations from specific services rendered by them to their members. So any kind of an association, some clubs or whatever, they are giving some services to their members. Even that will be what, bachu? Your income from PGBP. Can I say again, Rotary Club or any other Mahindra Club you were discussing and all of that? You know? For them, also it will be again PGBP income. We're just understanding what service given by an association or a club to their members. Which head of income basically? Again, PGBP. Understood? Then, the value of any benefit or perquisite, whether convertible into money or not, but very important. Arising from business or exercise of any profession. Okay. Now let us say there is a doctor. The doctor saved your life. Okay. You did not know the doctor before that. And you want to do something for that doctor. All right, Ilya, all of you. So you said, doctor, you saved my life. So let me give you discount in some particular of the things which you buy from me or something I will provide to you. I'll give you some discount. Or I will give it to you for free. Or you enjoy this or you enjoy that. Again, in that case, bacho, for the doctor, he is getting some benefit because of his profession. I understand it here, all of you. Okay. So any kind of benefit arising to a person because of the business or profession. Understood earlier, everybody? In the chapter of salaries, we saw same thing, benefit or perquisite what, but because of what relationship, bacho? Employer relationship, it was getting taxed in the head of income from salaries. Yes, all of you. Okay. Done.
Yes.
Anybody any doubt till now? Next one, the most important. Okay. Any interest, salary, bonus, commission or remuneration. Please pay attention. Salary also. By whatever name called, you may call it XYZ, special allowance, bonus, whatever you want to call it, okay? But due to or received by, okay? Due means it is accruing. Due to or received by a partner of a firm from such firm, bachcho. That means, pay attention. Any income from a partnership firm to its partner. Tell me, bachcho, for income tax purposes, partnership firm and LLP, is it same or not?
Yes.
It is same, okay? That means any income partner earns from the firm. Will it be any kind of interest on his capital, any salary, bonus, commission, whatever you want to call it. Even if you want to call it sitting fees also, whatever. Any income earned by partner bachcho from firm is which income?
PGBP.
Even please keep in mind salary also. Yes or no?
Yes.
Use now common sense. Please pay attention. Somebody's bachcho income is somebody's expenditure?
Yes.
Basic commerce, basic economics bachcho? Or vice versa? Somebody's expenditure is somebody's income. You know? All of you understood here?
Yeah.
Whether the partner and the firm, will they have separate income tax returns, separate PAN? Tell me this. PAN.
Yes.
Will they file separate income tax returns?
Yes.
The partner will show all of his income from the firm in his income tax return?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And now any other income which he may earn. Whatever. It can be fixed deposits or some other capital gain or anywhere else he's actually doing some job, whatever it can be. So total income he'll show in his income tax return. Right, everybody? Acha. Now, whatever the bachcho firm has paid to the partner. What did I say, bachcho? Firm has paid to the partner. Firm. Okay? All of you. Is that an expenditure for the firm?
Yes. Yes.
Is it a necessary expenditure? Necessary?
Yes.
Obviously.
Yes, remuneration.
Yes. So this expenditure will be reduced or not from the income of the firm?
Yes.
Are you understanding my point?
Yes.
Firm is also obviously going to earn some income, no? You know, gross receipts. Remember gross receipts?
Mm-hmm.
From this gross receipts, you are going to reduce some expenditure of the firm. Understood, everybody? And now what you'll get even for the firm will be what? Net profits. Firm. Yes, everybody. The firm will pay taxes on the net profit. Agreed? Everything is going logical or illogical? Tell me, you understanding or no? All of you.
Yes, understanding, yes, sir.
Achha. The firm will pay taxes at the rate of 30%, let us say. Whatever it can be.
Flat rate, yes.
Flat rate 30%, you know? I mean, I hope till you understood. Okay. So, firm was allowed the deduction of expenditure. So, any business or profession should be allowed deduction of expenditure from its gross receipts. Simple deal, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So, if any person, business or profession, they create a P&L or income and expenditure account, you know, profit and loss or income and expenditure, or you can say, receipts and expenditure account. Remember, Dalia? You have the receipt side, that is income side. All of you okay, Dalia? And then you have the expenditure side. Hena, all of you, T format. Clear? Mm-hmm. From the incomes, you will be allowed to reduce some expenditures. Hena? And the balance will be your profits, which the income tax department wishes to tax. Hena, everybody? And the expenditure, in this example, I'm telling you, the expenditure of the firm, Hena, bachcho? Will be income of the partner and it will be taxed in the hands of partner. Clear, everybody? Simple, Dalia? And let me ask you, what is the impact of one more section 10? Anybody? There is impact of one more section 10, bachcho? Anybody? The firm paid taxes on the net profit. And after net profit, what is remaining now? Profit after tax. Are you understanding all of you?
Yes, sir.
Oscar, Anurag, Ayush?
Yes, sir.
What is profit after tax? Okay, profit after tax will be shared with the partner or no?
Yes.
Profits. Achha. Is it now income or no of the partner?
Yes.
Okay. So it is income of the partner, but what will happen in the hands of partner? Tax in which head of income? Tax in PGB head of income.
PGB.
But taxable at what rate? Is it right?
No.
Kya hai? 10-2 is what?
Share of profit.
10-2 is share of profit or 10-2 is, I mean, which HUF or partnership firm?
Partners from the firm. Share of profit received from partners of the firm.
That is 10-2A, na?
Yes.
And 10-2 was correct. HUF, remember?
HUF. Yes.
All of you understood or no? So even the profits from the firm, obviously after tax, is paid to the partner. It is his income from PGBP. No problem about that. But that is exempt. No, bachcho. Do you know this or no? Very basic. Hai na?
Yes.
All of you understood earlier? I'm just giving a scenario over here. A scenario. Understood everybody?
Yes, sir.
So entire income earned by the partner from the firm is PGBP income. That's it. Including salary as well as profits. Profits will not be taxed because it was already taxed. I hope all of you understood in here. Anna? All right. Fine. Then some other points which we will understand later on. Don't worry. Any sum on account of any capital asset other than land or goodwill or financial instrument being demolished, destroyed, discarded, or transferred. If the whole of the expenditure on such capital asset has been allowed as deduction under Section 35AD. So when you go to Section 35AD, that time we will see, okay, that it is a business income. It will be taxed in this head of income. Export incentives, some you can say benefits you are getting for exporting the units outside, exporting your goods or services outside India. Some benefits from the government of India. Okay, some cash incentive, if it you are getting. You understand the word which incentives?
Yes, sir.
It is like a commission or bonus for doing based on your performance. Right?
Yes.
Then compensation or other payment to a person managing the whole or substantially the whole of the affairs of a company or company at termination of his management or office or modification of any terms and conditions. Then person holding any agency in India at or in connection with termination of the or in connection with termination of the agency or modification or any terms and conditions. Basically, again, a person who was managing a business, a person who was managing a business of the company or managing any agency. Okay. And that agency is getting what, bachcho? Either terminated or modification. Terminated or modification. And because of that, there is a kind of a some compensation given. Some compensation given. Bachcho, for example, remember the concept of retrenchment in salaries or voluntary retirement?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And when you say voluntary retirement, it is still there is a modification in the terms of contract, employer-employee contract.
Hmm.
Hai na? So whenever now that compensation was given, that was charged in the income of salaries. But here, when the person was managing the entire business and his kind of contract is being changed, okay, and for that he is given some compensation, that will be again your PGBP income. Okay, everybody. Then we are just checking examples which are falling under head of this charging section. Again, another very important. Non-compete fees, non-compete income, very important, you can say section or you can say concept. What do you mean by non-compete? You might have done this in your foundation law, if at all you are from foundation. Is it earning income for not doing something?
Yes.
Earning income for not doing something. You will not manufacture or provide services of our same product or services. A person is paying to another person. Paying to another person for telling him that you will not do the same business or profession in my city, my area, or for n number of years or whatever. Hai na bachcho? Remember till here?
Yes.
That is non-compete fees.
Champati?
Champati is different. You were paying fees for what? Filing case na, wo to aisa tha na wo.
Maintenance and Champati.
That was different, huh? So non-compete means you will not do business, na? Or let us say if a partner is retiring from the firm. Example, a partner is retiring from the firm, so the partner may not be allowed to do same business in the same locality. That may also be there. It depends from the contract to contract, you know? So any sum, whether received or receivable in cash or in kind, under an agreement, under a mature agreement, but what? For not carrying out any activity in relation to any business or profession, okay? Or not to share any know-how, knowledge, patent, copyright, trademark. That means you are acquiring that as a license, something, you know? License, franchisee, or any other business or commercial right of similar nature, or information or technique likely to assist in manufacturing or processing goods or provision of services. Same thing. I mean, it is going to help a particular person to do some kind of manufacturing or providing of some particular service. All right. Let us say somebody has particular scientific formula. You know, all of you. You know, and then you are buying that formula. Or you're saying that, okay, you have the formula, but you will obviously not share the formula. Or you have the knowledge, you have done the research, you will not share this knowledge or research with anyone else. We are being a non-compete. Understood, everybody? You will get patent, or you will get license, or you will get, let us say, royalty after every product which is sold. Are you understanding, everybody? Usually, patent works like that. Do you know the meaning of the word patent?
Yes, sir.
Whoever has created and invented that process, he gets what, but your royalty. For every goods or service which is sold, it can be based on that also. Like, for example, again, an author. Again, I'm giving you an example. Tell me, bachcho. Author. His income will be what? This head of income or not? Are you understanding? An author sells a book. An author sells a book. Mm-hmm. Are you all understanding here?
Yes.
But there is a publishing house. Publishing house. Are you understanding on all of you? The author is paid what? Royalty. Hai na? Based on what, bachcho? Based on obviously number of books which are sold. Based on number of books which are sold. Understood, everybody? Tell you? Fine?
Yes.
Then, proceeds of any key man insurance policy. What do you mean by the key man?
He's a personal.
Main person.
So you can see again the main person of the company, or you can see business or profession. Just like in company law, you have what? KMP, key managerial personnel, right?
Director.
Yes. So check. So if at all in the business, now pay attention. We're talking about again PGBP. You know, there is a business, and for that business, there is a, I'm just using the word KMP, okay? Key managerial personnel. And this business is mainly dependent on this person. That means, again, if this person is not working tomorrow, if he leaves the business or he dies or whatever, the business may come into a loss or it may not continue. So to protect the business, or you can say profession, from such situation, are you understanding here? It is mainly dependent on this KMP person, okay, this person. And if tomorrow the KMP leaves, retires, resigns, dies, whatever, okay, the business will be impacted. So to save the business or to protect the business from such situation, they may take a insurance policy in his name. Isn't it, bachcho? Are you all understanding? All
yes.
Of you? Have you heard of that, bachcho, footballer Pele?
Yes, sir.
You know what did he get insured for? What separately he had a big insurance amount for? Not just for his life or health. He had his legs insured. Okay, because if he doesn't have as some, you know, understood? I mean, because he's earning main income by playing football, which uses legs and all. So he had a separate contract, or can say insurance only for his legs. Okay. Understood, everybody? Anyways. So any sum, pay attention, received under a Cayman insurance policy. Who is receiving the income, bachcho?
Employer.
You can say employer, or can say business. Correct. Yes. So any sum received under a Cayman insurance policy, including sum allocated by way of bonus. See, when you don't claim the policy, when there is no claim on the policy, you earn bonus. Are you aware of that? You'll keep on paying premium. Are you understanding or no? But if there is no loss at all, then the insurance company can also pay you some bonus. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Anyways, and such policy will be taxable as income from business for the business owner. Everyone understood earlier?
Yes, sir.
And fair market value of inventory on its conversion of capital asset. That we will see later on. Okay. Those examples also we will see. Now, fair market value of inventory into capital asset means what? What do you mean by inventory, bachcho? Can I say stock and trade?
Yes.
Yes.
Or trading asset, hai na?
Assets held for sale, huh?
Correct. Stock and trade or trading asset. And then once you're converting that stock and trade into your own capital asset. Let us say a jewelry shop owner. Jewelry shop owner. All right, everybody? So the jewelry shown in the shop, is it stock and trade or capital asset for the shop owner?
Stock and trade.
And if he says, okay, he wants to gift it to his wife and he brings it home.
Capital asset.
Now that becomes to what? Then capital asset. Isn't it? All of you understand earlier?
Yeah.
The same thing with the builder, real estate. When he's going to sell the flats, it is stock and trade. But if he keeps it for his own personal use, it becomes
capital asset.
But ultimately what happened? He's changing the nature or he's bringing it out of PGPP. Okay. In that case, again, PGPP will be applicable. Understood everybody earlier? Got it? So incomes, see, please pay attention. This chapter will not much talk about income. Okay. This chapter, but you will talk mainly about expenditure. Please pay attention. Okay.
Okay.
That means which expenditure will be allowed, which will not be allowed. Understood or no? If you remember the chapter of salaries, again, I had clearly told you which words not to be confused with this chapter. A particular word which will have lots of, you can say, confusion was the word, bachcho, allowance. Hai na? Everybody? All of you?
Yes.
Whenever, now we are talking of expenditure is allowed. Allowed or not allowed, what but? As deduction. Understood? Are you understanding now? Expenditure allowed as deduction means what, bachcho? That expenditure will be allowed to be reduced from income. Gross receipts. Yes,
gross
or no?
Total income. Yes, sir.
Not gross total income. Gross receipts of the business or profession.
Oh, right.
Let us say expenditure not allowed as deduction means what? That expenditure will not be allowed to be reduced from your gross receipt.
Gross receipts. Hmm.
You understand till here now?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I again use this word, bachcho, allowed, okay? There may be situation in the chapter or your language. They may use the word, bachcho, allowance. Okay? They may use the word. Again, you have to understand, they are just talking about allowed expenditure. Okay? But not allowed, they may use the word, bachcho, disallowance or disallowed. Disallowed or disallowance. Did you understand? It is just a normal English word which says allowed or not allowed. Okay. All of you agreed or not agreed? Yes. Okay. Now you understand, bachcho. Please pay attention. If accounting is done, okay, let us say, if accounting is done of a business or professional, whatever. These are income sides and gross receipts, sales and all. Right, everybody? These are expenses. Indirect expenses. Barabar, all of you? Now, let us say, bachcho, I'm just giving an example. Let us say he goes to Australia for his personal visit, personal tour. Okay, personal tour. And he has booked the expenditure. Whenever I'll use the word, bachcho, booked, it means what? Entry has been made in your books of account. Booked means the entry has been made in your books of account. Okay, tell you, all of you, done tell you. If he goes on a personal tour, okay, everybody? Yes? And let us say that personal tour has nothing to do with the business. But when he was going for his personal tour to Australia, he put all the cab expenditure. Cab, you understand, no? Traveling expenditure. He has shown it as, let us say, a business expenditure. Okay? And then he booked it. Or he has put it as a debit item in his books of account. Are you understanding earlier? Whatever it meant. Whatever figure. Okay. Whatever figure.
Yes, sir.
Now, from his total sales, we are reducing all the expenditure, and as such, whatever is debited, because we are going to see the books of account, and we got bachcho what, let us say net profit. Okay, all of you understood earlier? This is as per the books of account or no? This is as per his books of account, correct?
Yeah.
For income tax, we will see net profit. All of you understood earlier? But you tell me, bachcho, whether this expenditure will be allowed as deduction or not?
No.
So I will use the word disallowed. Understood, everybody?
Yes.
Everybody understood or no?
Yes.
I will use the word what bachcho? Disallowance or disallowed or not allowed. Clear till here? Everybody? Now let us see if I give you some very simple numbers. Let us say my sales is total 500. Example, okay. My other expenditures are, let us say 300. All right, okay, tell you everybody. And this personal tour, whatever expenditure was, let us say 50 rupees. All right, everybody. What is my net profit showing right now? 150.
Yes.
And for what income tax purposes, what do you think should we do? If at all we will not allow the expenditure of 50, what will happen to my net profit?
50 rupees add back honge.
All of you, I will add or not add in my 150 rupees net profit? Add. Everybody, understood? Pushkar, Vidhi?
Yes, sir.
Anurag, Ayush, Harsh? And all of you got it earlier?
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir. Okay. Done, everybody? Okay. So I will add back. All right, everybody? So one thing you have to understand in this PGBP chapter is that, see, your books of account and for the purpose of income tax, okay, it may obviously not match. It may not match. There can be at times some accounting mistakes also. You know? Let us say there can be some capital expenditure also over here. Capital expenditure. You understand, no? Revenue expenditure and capital expenditure. You know?
Yes.
So use again common sense. If I'm going to tax this income, is what, capital income or my revenue income?
Revenue.
My business, from my business or profession, is what, bachcho, my revenue income. So from a revenue income, how can I reduce capital expenditure? Not allowed. Not logical, no, bachcho. You know? So if there is some accounting mistake, some problem or something like that, then what will happen? We'll have to adjust all these things. You know? We'll have to reduce. We'll have to kind of rectify the books of account. You know? All of you understood earlier?
Yes, sir.
Pakka?
Yes, sir.
So all these things we have to basically adjust. Okay? So check. Subsidy. Even subsidy is an income, but to tell me.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
All of you? Subsidy is an income?
Yeah.
Yeah. It is some kind of, again, benefit given. No? Let us see if I say cash subsidy. Or it can be also, bachcho, let us say rebate, okay? Or discount. Now pay attention how it actually works. There is, by the way, a separate set of practice for subsidy practice only. Means many chartered accountants also work only in subsidy practice or mainly in subsidy practice. Do you know that? It means, achha, by the way, who provides subsidy, bachcho?
Government.
Who provides
government.
Government. Again, government are two types, central and state. Mm-hmm. So yes. There are some subsidies by central government, some subsidies by state government. And many, many, many subsidies state-specific. State, department-specific. Department. Okay, that means you might have heard about that for sheep or goat, if at all you start that business, there is subsidy. Then fisheries, then honeybee and all of that. There are many, many, many subsidies, okay, which the government wants to promote. Yes? Which the government wants to promote. Understood, Leo? Now pay attention. What kind of subsidies can be there? I'm just giving you an example. There can be directly cash subsidy. Now pay attention. What happens? I'm giving you a practical example. Let us say there is a business, okay? And that business wants to purchase a plant and machinery. Clear, everybody? Tell you?
Yes, sir.
the government says that, okay, if at all you are this particular type of business, you are in that particular location, whatever, that some conditions are there. And if at all you spend 100 rupees on this plant and machinery, okay, you show us the invoice proof, etc. of this 100 rupees, we will contribute or we will pay you back 15 rupees. Understood earlier?
Yes, sir.
Effectively, for the assessee, his plant and machinery cost is how much?
85.
But is this 15 rupees is income or not? That is his income.
Income.
He got a benefit. Again, use common sense. What did we see over here? The value of any benefit or perquisites, whether convertible into money or not, arising from business or exercise of any profession. Understood?
Yep.
You got benefit because of doing business. The subsidy is taxable under PGB, but you have to again use common sense. Again, what I'm trying to tell you. Pay attention. This is one of the examples I told you, okay? That you got 15 rupees benefit for buying a plant and machinery. There are other benefits also, or other schemes. There are lots of schemes. Okay, pay attention. Electricity, bachcho. Understood? Electricity, you understand, no? So now, electricity, bachcho, the company or any business, okay, it is paying electricity bills monthly basis, you know? And the government says that, okay, we will contribute rupees 50, paisa, matlab. Rupees 50 for each unit of consumption. These are the benefits also given. Are you understanding? Now let us say the unit rate may be 2 rupees, 3 rupees, whatever it might be per unit. You understand this, no? Of the electricity. And the government says, okay, for every consumption of unit, we will pay you 50 paisa. Again, in cash. You again submit the bills, payment and all of that. We will pay you cash. Did you all understand or no? Everybody?
Yes.
Understood or no?
Yes.
Again, this cash is a subsidy or a benefit or not to the assessee? All of you? Are hi, Anna. It is a benefit to the assessee or no?
Yes.
Cash. I'm using the word cash. Okay? Now, whatever that amount will come to. Okay? Now, pay attention, bachcho. Still, I'm telling you still, not both of them will go under PGBP. Both the subsidies will not go under PGBP. Which of them will go under PGBP? What do you think?
Plant and machinery wali.
Okay, because it is used in business.
Yes.
And electricity for what? Diwali? Or rocket?
No.
Then?
No.
Rocket launching then?
Also for business.
Okay, then? But plant and machinery is more important than electricity. That means plant and machinery can work without electricity.
Anna? No.
Okay, then? Answer change.
Sir, plant and machinery ka capital honga aur ye revenue expenditure hai na.
Okay. In fact, you're using the correct logic but giving wrong answer. Others can also answer. Only both the subsidy will not be under PGBP. Only one of them will go. Anybody? But what is the reason? It's a reason. Fine, Andhura. Reason. Pushkar, Tripti, kuch to bolo. Very good, Anura. Because it is, see, you have to understand, PGBP, what did I tell you mainly, talks about revenue, no? Revenue item, revenue income or revenue expenditure only. You know? If at all you are buying plant and machinery, spend on plant and machinery, is your capital expenditure or revenue expenditure?
Capital expenditure.
Obviously, this is capital expenditure. Mm. Do we allow capital expenditure even in our P&L as such?
No.
Do we debit our P&L?
No.
Plot and loss? No. No. So even this 15 rupees benefit which you got, that is because of capital expenditure. So even this 15 rupees will be treated as bachcho capital income. Understood? So it is not your revenue income. It will not be PGBP. This will in fact go under capital gain chapter. Understood, everybody? But
yes, sir.
This cash, whichever you received, rupees 50 per unit, it was because of revenue expenditure. See, with this cash subsidy which you got, will take its color or borrow its color from this main income, electricity, not income, sorry, expenditure, electricity expenditure, which is revenue in nature. So PGBP, again, use common sense, use a normal thing. PGBP is mainly income, is involved only with revenue. Revenue income, revenue expenditure. Clear? Whatever is not revenue, leave it. Understood or no?
Yeah.
It has to be obviously based, or it has to be obviously based completely on the business or profession, but it also has to be revenue. Isn't it all of you understood here?
Yeah.
Anna? So these things you'll understand dire, slowly. But like how it impacts your computation. Understood all of you? What is to be taken and what is not to be taken. Right? All of you got it, Ilya?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Fine. So check. Assistance in the form of any subsidy or grant or cash. Do you have this accounting channel also? You have no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
AS 12.
Hmm.
Government.
Or duty drawback. Again, refund. Okay. Or waiver. Or concession or reimbursement shall be treated as income of the assessee. Okay. Now I told you between that capital subsidy and revenue subsidy, that is a matter of, you can say, extra knowledge or research and all. Okay. Fine. Anyways. But again, I'm giving you something more in the class. So subsidy or grant or reimbursement relating to the asset shall be reduced from the actual cost of the asset. Means what did you understand? I had given you this example that planted machinery is of 100 rupees. Yes. Did this you purchase it for? And you got what, Bachchu? Let us say 15 rupees as subsidy from the government. Then what, on which amount will you give depreciation? 100 or
85.
Yes, because that subsidy will be, Bachchu, reduced from the actual cost of the asset. So you'll give depreciation on 85 rupees. Are you understanding or no, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Subsidies received in personal capacity, like LPG, whatever, etc., that will not be taxable at all. Are you understanding? Let us say if you are tomorrow doing business and still you get some subsidy in personal capacity, that has nothing to do with your business. No. LPG subsidy you get or any other subsidy you get, Bachcho, and that is because you are just a citizen of India. That's it. It has nothing to do with your business. Okay. So your personal subsidies which you get, that is not taxable in this head of it. Anna, all of you? Okay. Then. Subsidy or grant by CG, by central government, for the purpose of corpus of a trust. Corpus means the first amount which goes to the trust. Okay. The main balance. Okay. Huh. That can be allowed. Yes. 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 But if at all you will see that the gas connection itself is different. If at all you do it legally, there is a direct blue color cylinder. If you know, he's asking me about LPG subsidy for catering business. So the restaurants will check. They don't get our regular red color cylinder. Mm-hmm. Yeah, all of you aware or no? Red color cylinder.
Domestic.
But also, it is, I think it is 15 kg or something. Been long. Okay, I have not. I mean, now we have that gas pipeline, so I don't remember. But correct, no? 15 kg, I think. Uska rakh sahi hai na?
15.2.
I hope all of you have done that work. Removal of and putting again, hai na? Right. Or calling the gas. Paying fixed. Now, how much is this? 700, 800 going on, na? Now?
Ah, sir.
Very costly.
800, no, sir.
Wow, see, I'm not even aware.
25 rupaye bhi lete.
Sorry?
25 rupaye extra lete, phir.
Achha, haan, for delivery, na, like, look. Yeah. Correct. So, yeah.
We don't have.
So, for that, you know, that cylinders which we get red in color, no? All of you get, I hope, red in color only.
Yes,
right?
Yes, sir.
That is for personal consumption or residential consumption, Anurag. The one used in restaurants or catering, they have to be blue in color, and they usually, quantity is also like 20 kg. Size, I think, is 20 kg. Because it is industrial.
Nowadays, sir, in catering business also, they provide pipeline gas, no?
Depends. Catering can be, if that is what you can say, movable, then what? Movable, understand?
No, they use blue color glass.
But most of the restaurants, they are having.
Restaurants may have. But the connection again will be different. No? Yes. It is not for पर्सनल कंजम्पशन ऐसा है ना. एनीवेज सो सब्सिडी और अ ग्रांट बाय सीजी फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ कॉर्पस ऑफ अ ट्रस्ट और इंस्टीट्यूशन एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय सीजी नथिंग ग्रेट. सो ट्रस्ट और इंस्टीट्यूशन इटसेल्फ इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय सीजी एंड सीजी इज कंट्रीब्यूटिंग इट इज नॉट यार इट इज नॉट इनकम ओके. सो ट्रस्ट और सम इंस्टीट्यूट है ना आईआईटी एक्सेट्रा सम बिग नेशनल केमिकल लैबोरेटरी व्हाटएवर इट इज ओके. Those institutes which are created by CG and contribution also by CG, that is not, you can say, income or you can say benefit because of business or profession. Okay, done, all of you? Check. Method of accounting, but we are going in section 145 now. Income chargeable under the head, bachcho, PGBP or as well as IOS shall be computed either as per cash or mercantile system of accounting regularly employed by the assessee. That means both of them are allowed. So which one? Cash or mercantile accrual basis. Okay. Ayana, understood earlier? So you are free to choose. But you cannot keep on changing it regularly. Okay. There has to be a strong reason for change of the accounting system. Understood everybody? Or method of accounting. Yes. All of you. सब मर गए क्या?
हाँ सर समझा.
बोला को हर्ष का माइक ही बंद है जी. नॉट करेक्ट ऑडियो कट ऑफ. ओके फाइन. तृप्ति यू कैन आल्सो से समथिंग. ओके मृदमय यू आल्सो माधुरी यू आल्सो. ओके यस ठीक है. सेक्शन 29 डिड वी सी बच्चों व्हाट इज 28. दे आर गिविंग यू लिस्ट ऑफ इनकम्स व्हिच विल बी टैक्स अंडर दिस चैप्टर है ना एवरीबॉडी. Section 28 itself is saying that these incomes will be taxed under this head of income. Hai na? All of you?
Yes.
We have seen some examples. All right. 29 says what? Computation of income from business. That means again, this is helping you to compute income for this chapter. Hai na? On which we are going to take tax. Hai na, all of you? Done? So check. According to Section 29, please, this is again important. Na? The profits and gains of any business or profession are to be computed in accordance with the provisions contained in section 30 to 43D. All right. It is clearly telling you, achha, these are the sections you have to follow. This will all the sections from 30 to 43D will help you in computation of income from business or profession. Understood? All of you? Everybody? Achha. It must, however, be remembered that in addition to specific allowances, for the final time, I'm repeating. What do you mean by allowances? Allowed. Clear? Allowances in this chapter means what, bachcho? Allowed. Clear?
Yes.
And mainly this chapter will be talking about expenditure allowed or not. Clear hai, all of you? So specific allowances and deductions. Now, when I say deductions, it means allowed or not allowed? Allowed.
Allowed.
Deduction again allowed. Okay, expenditure allowed. Okay, so pay attention. So again, it should be kept in mind that specific allowance and deduction stated in section 30 to 36. Okay. The Act further permits allowance of items of expenses, expenditure allowed under section residuary section 37.1. We'll come to that, don't worry. But keep in mind they are using the word what's what? Residuary section 37.1, subsection 1. Okay. Again, I'm repeating. Some specific allowances and deductions are given where? From 30 to 36. Allowed expenditures, allowed deductions. Okay, check over here. That is the first thing you're going to see. You know? Some expenditure which is allowed specifically told to us, you can take this. You can take the deduction. It will be allowed.
Yeah. Yes,
sir. As well as if it is not given from 30 to 36. Even if it is not given from 30 to 36, some residuary is given to us. Balancing deduction section is given to us. Section 37.
Okay. Section
37. So 30 to 36 is specific. 37 is general deductions. Understood? Obviously, it has, every section has its own set of rules, conditions, and all of that. That we will see. Understood, everybody?
Mm.
So residuary deduction is given under section 37.1. Which extends to allowances of items of business expenditure, which are not covered by 30 to 36. Did you understand this or not? What did I just tell you? 30 to 36 will give you some specific items. And now whatever is missed, not covered in 30 to 36, it may be given deduction under section
37 residuary.
All of you, Anurag, Pushkar, Drupti, understood?
Yes, sir.
Where these are allowable according to the accepted commercial practice. That we will see. What is about 37? 30 to 36 is actually very, very specific. 37 is a general deduction. It will be allowed. If it is not covered under 30 to 36. Clear, everybody?
Mm, yes, sir.
Now we are coming to allowable deductions from section 30 to 36. Done, everybody?
Mm, yes.
We are focusing where? P&L income or P&L expenditure?
P&L expenditure.
P&L expenditure. Clear, eh?
Yes.
Now, income tax law doesn't give a damn, doesn't care at all about your books of account. Okay? Your accountant may be a good person, bad person, genuine, superior, fool, whatever. Income tax department law says whatever is written from 30 to 36 or 37, only that will be allowed as deduction. That means the main work which we have to do in this chapter is reconciliation, or basically check what is given in books of account, what is wrong in that books of account, and remove the wrong part. Or check in the books of account what is missing in that books of account and put the correct part over there. Did you understand this or not? A little bit basics.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So books of accounts may be right, may be wrong, whatever treatment they have would have given as per accounting standards, as per any other standards, whatever it might be. Income tax says you have to allow only these expenditures which we tell you. Okay, nothing extra over there. Understood?
Yes.
So only if it falls from 30 to 36 or 37, only then it will be allowed. Otherwise, nothing to be done over there. Understood? Right. Like I told you, na bachcho, for by mistake in the books of account, some capital expenditure is booked. Capital expenditure is booked means some capital expense is shown in the books of account. In P&L, will you allow it? No. Income tax law says no. Even if by mistake you have put in books of accounts, your net profit is there, everything is there, then what will you do? You'll have to remove that capital expenditure. Are you all understand till here?
Yes, sir.
So stay safe at home. Okay. Fine. Let's go ahead, everybody. Allowable deductions, okay? Section 30. 28, charging section. All the incomes which are again told to us will be taxed in this head of income. 29 is telling you just follow the computation. That's it. Very chilled section 29. Okay. Nothing. They are just saying that follow this chapter. So 30 to 37 overall will be some allowed deductions. Clear, everybody? All of you?
Yes, sir.
30.
Yes, sir.
Rents, rates, taxes, repairs, and insurance for building. For building. Can I say plant and machinery or just building?
Building. Just building.
Here we have bachcho plant, machinery, and furniture. Both of them, let us say, are capital assets. Obviously. Yes or no? Bachcho.
Yes, sir.
They are capital assets, correct? Using business, profession, whatever it is. You know? Even computers, bachcho, will fall under this plant and machinery. Okay? Printer, computers, whatever it can be.
Okay?
And building, again, your office. Again, please don't understand building means a tall building and skyscraper, 5-10 floor. No, it can be a small structure also. And all of you just should have walls and a roof. It is a building. Okay, fine, everybody. Let us see. If you tell you own an office, 10 by 10 square feet, 100 square feet total. Even if you are owning that small shop, a small mobile repairer, let us say. He is owning, but let us say, not rent, owning. Office, whatever it can be, a very small shop also. That is again a building for him, okay? Yes or no? Where you check from books of account point of view, no? If you are owning a shop or office premises, where will you book it in your balance sheet? Under which category? Building? Yes or no? Will you put it in plant and machinery? Everybody?
No.
Okay. Everybody got it till here?
Yes.
Okay, fine. We'll come to the other things later on.
So where a building is... This is, I think, case of house property, no? I mean, house property used for a professional or businesses.
If it is owned. Correct.
If it is owned.
That's why we are coming into PGBP only, no? That's why I told you what? We will exclude house property chapter itself. If you are owning the property and using for business purpose, no? Understood or no? That's why we excluded from the chapter of PGP, from the chapter of HP itself, house property itself. You know, all of you? There is some example, obviously, where you're using building for main business. Now, how do I tell you that? I mean, leave it. Chalo. I mean, as a plant and machinery, which means we will come to that. When the building is used over there, you're having a main income. Let us say like commercial halls, your lawns or halls, which you use for wedding, birthdays and all of that. It is just a building. Na? You don't have plant and machinery asset. But again, your main source of income is because of the space, building. I understand it earlier, all of you.
Okay? Yes, sir.
But still, I'll do those examples. Don't worry. Yes, no. But rents, rates, and taxes, repairs, and insurance for building. Clear? Assessee is owning the building and he's spending all this money. Rent, maybe. Or rates, taxes, repairs, and even insurance. Clear, all of you? Yes? Hi, Anna.
Yes, sir.
Even if you are not owning the office or not owning the building, you may be paying rent, bachcho. Hai na? Again, if there is some agreement between the landlord and you as a tenant, I hope you're understanding now you are in whose shoes now? You are now in tenant's shoes. Hai na? You are paying rent to use a, let us say, office. Even that is the case. So if you're spending on rates, taxes, whatever, even that will be allowed as deduction. Section 30, overall 37, it is about allowed expenditure. Hai na, all of you? So, fallen deduction shall be allowed. Pay attention. Where the premises are occupied by the assessee. Hai na? Occupied means he's using it. But as a tenant, is he owning it? No. So, rent paid for such premises. And further, if he has undertaken to bear the cost of repairs to the premises, even such cost will be allowed. I understand earlier. So, he enters into some agreement with the owner or he tells that, no. Even the repairs, I will take care of it. So, even this repairs, whatever small things he has to do, even that will be allowed as a deduction. Clear? Then again, when the premises are occupied by the assessee, but otherwise then as a tenant means what, bachcho? Obviously, he's his own owner. Correct. Yes. You know? The amount paid by him on account of even only just bachcho current repair. That means what? What about rent? Is there any notional rent concept over here? Are you understanding or no? Is there any concept of notional rent? Notional, you understand?
Yes.
Assumed rent, are we putting over here? Is there any actual rent expense?
No.
So that will not be allowed as deduction. And you will not show any notional rent expense. Clear? All of you?
Yes.
Lastly, any sums paid for land revenue, local rates, or municipal taxes, but your property taxes, if paid by the assessee. Okay, all of you?
Yes.
If paid by the assessee. And again, as an owner or as a tenant. Clear, all of you? And premium for insurance against the risk of damage or destruction of the premise. Insurance policy premium, bachcho. But is insurance policy premium is for what purpose? For, again, security and maintenance of the building.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody? But which deduction shall not be allowed? Obviously, common sense. Capital expenditure will not be allowed. Henna, all of you? Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Please be very, very careful. Again, it is a matter of accounting and practically you have to check that which expenses, repairs specifically, but to repairs will fall under revenue expenditure and capital expenditure. Clear? How do you tell me, but from accounting point of view, tell me which repairs you can put into capital and which repairs you can put into revenue, Bachu? Any example you can think? How do you say, bachchu, capital expenditure?
Very good.
Yes.
Bolo, Vidhi.
One which will increase the efficiency of the machinery.
Barabar, of the asset. So that expenditure which increases the efficiency of the asset or life of the asset, yes?
Yes.
That will be our?
Capital expenditure.
Which maintains the efficiency or maintains the life?
Revenue.
If I say, again, I'm giving you an example, computer. Or let us say AC. Okay. And we had discussed this concept of AMC, annual maintenance cost, contract, annual maintenance contract. You know, all of you? Remember or no? So there is a, let us say, a vendor or provider. He comes once in a year. He cleans your computer. He does everything, removes the software, puts the software again. whatever, you will check the updates, whatever it is, you know? Same thing, he'll come, he'll open the AC, he'll clean it, that's it. Did he increase the life of the asset?
No.
What was originally intended for AC, let us say 10 years, computer, let us say 5 years. Is he increasing the life? He's just maintaining the life. Okay? But pay attention. Okay. So this expenditure of AMC will be which expenditure, which is revenue or capital?
Revenue.
But let us say, I want to, my computer has just 1 GB RAM, example, okay? Usually in the office of CA, Baba Azam ke zamane ke computer, na, 10 years, 20 years old, 1 GB RAM, it takes half an hour to start the computer, na? It takes 1 hour to switch off the computer, hai ne, bacho? It takes 2 hours to open the Excel sheet, and that is how your day is wasted. Na? And then the principal complains, why you're not working? So you tell them, aray sir, 8 GB ka zamana hai, na? 8 GB you have to put now, hai na, bacho? Isn't it? So once you replace in that computer or laptop, whatever, the RAM from 1 GB to 8 GB, what is this? Is it maintenance of life or this is efficiency?
If it increases in efficiency.
What will you put this expenditure as? Revenue or capital?
Capital.
Exactly. This is what you have to understand. This will obviously impact everywhere. Na, yaar. This will impact your books of accounts, balance sheet, P&L, or even your, even from now, from income tax point of view. Na? Again, common sense. If it is capital expenditure on an asset, do you get some benefit or not still? From income tax point of view or from your accounting point of view? Yes, you get benefit in the name of? You do get, you know, in the name of depreciation. But if at all it is a revenue expenditure, it is a direct debit item in P&L, direct full amount. Yes or no? All of you understanding or no?
Yes.
Simple or no? This is very, very basic still now. Right, everybody?
Yes.
So if it is revenue expenditure, yes, direct debit in P&L, we are claiming it fully. But if it is capital, specifically for asset, you know, we can claim obviously depreciation also on the same. The entire expense on capital asset, we will not going to claim it immediately. We are going to take it on throughout the life of the asset in the form of what? Depreciation. Hena bachcho? Done till your?
Yes.
All right. And same thing for bachcho. Repairs and insurance for plant and machinery or even furniture. Okay. Even furniture. Repairs and insurance. We don't have rent, so rates is not given to us over here. Na? Check. So amount paid for current repairs, again revenue, not your capital amount, and any premium paid for insurance against risk of damage or destruction thereof. Whose bachcho, destruction or damage, plant and machinery or furniture, will be allowed as deduction. Clear? That means if you don't have P&L debit, these items are being shown, it will be allowed. We will keep it untouched. They will do nothing about it. Na bachcho, done till here? Again, but again, which is not allowed in both the cases? Capital expenses. All right. Done, all of you?
Yes, sir.
That is just the basics for today. Then from the next lecture, we start with some competition, something I will understand better or more. So it was just a normal discussion for today's chapter. And everybody, done, anybody, any doubt till now?
No.
Please go through the notes. Just one homework will always be there. Please read ICA study material. Always, always, always. Okay.
Yes.
I may have to skip because chapters are at times big. So I may have to skip some theory parts. Like for today, I skipped this part, meaning of profits and all. Okay. So please go through it. That much you can do, all of you.
Yes, sir.
Fine.
Yes,
sir. So then see you in now next lecture. Right?
Yeah.
Ta-da.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.